Okay, this is the project we are doing on this video. I have titled this one Cup of Tea, and I do not know what is wrong with my lighting all of a sudden. I have the exact same lights that I've been using. I think one of them might be getting ready to burn out, my under counter lights. So the lighting comes and goes on this, and I do apologize for that in advance. So let's get busy on this project. It was a fun one to do. It's a quick one, it's easy, and you're going to have a lot of fun doing it. Alright, I'm putting my first base coats on this project. The background I painted with two coats of light buttermilk, and I mixed in some multi-purpose sealer and with my paint and applied two coats. I mixed about equal amounts. I've just got the one coat on the blueberries for now. It's Blue Harbor. And now I'm painting in the leaves with their first coat with avocado. And I just wanted to show you that when I'm doing these leaves, let me zoom you in here, I'm trying to give them a jagged edge. So I'm just using a round brush and I'm just making a like zigzag edge. I'll flip it around and make a zigzag edge over here. I want to try and keep that edge when I paint the edge of it later. If you don't want to do that at first, you can always come back and do it in later, but gives me a little bit of a guideline where I want to go, because the leaves on these blueberries have very jagged edges. Not great big jags, just little jags that you can see. They look great big probably to you because we're zoomed way in. Okay, let me wide angle out, and then we're going to paint the coffee cup here. Now, I want to paint the inside of the coffee cup with cool white. And we'll do all of our base coats. We'll get two coats. I'm just showing you the first coat here, and then I'll go off camera and apply the second coat. So we're going to fill this in, and then the underneath on the plate, I think I want that to be a little bit darker. So before I go on, I want to have mixed some paint here. So let me get my palette knife. So I've got my cool white, and you can see it's got a little bit of a blue tint to it, which I really like. Because then when you go and apply your white, snow white on top of it, your paint already has that little bit of tint to it, so the white shows up really well. So I want to take just a little dot of Blue Harbor. I'm going to put it up here because that might be too much. I want to mix this in. I want to just get this a little bit bluer than what it was. Just slightly bluer. Okay, you can sort of see the difference there. So I just basically dirtied up that cool white. So I'm going to start with the cool white down here. This is just the straight cool white on this part of the plate. I'm going to work very quickly because I want to blend these two together, and then I'm going to go into the paint that I mixed and add it in here. It's a little darker back there in those shadow areas, and then just gently blend it together where it comes together. And if there's such a glare on that, you probably can't even see the two different colors there. This is going to be more in the shadow area back here. I'm going to wipe my brush off so I can blend these colors together right here. Okay, now I want this cool white mix to be the one that I mixed the blue in. I want it to be down here. This is the edge of the plate that kind of gives it a little dimension. And then we're going to, actually I might want that to be white, so I might change my mind on my second coat here. This is the cool white mix here, so you can really see the difference between the two now. This one up here inside the cup is straight cool white. If you work from the middle out, you can help not get ridges on your project. Don't push really hard when you're at the edge so you don't get any kind of ridge buildup, but if you do, just take your finger and gently go across that paint, very gently, pushing it in towards your painted area, and it will remove that ridge if you do it before it has time to dry. Okay, so I'm painting my areas in individually so that I can retain the lines. So I can see where every separation is on my teacup. And the handle I want to paint in with just straight cool white. So I'm going to go back to my round brush here. And then I'm going to go off camera and apply the second coats. And before we do anything to our project, our cup and saucer, or our blueberries, we're going to work on the background first. Okay. So there's our first coats. You can kind of see the little bit of color variation there, and a little bit, you can see it a little bit more down here than you can on this side. I probably still had a little bit too much white still in my brush. So I'm going to get this completely dry and then go apply the second coats. Alright, we've got our two coats on here. We're going to let that get dry completely. I'm going to erase any graphite lines that I can that I didn't paint over. Once you paint over them, they're in your project. So you'll have to be sure, and you know, if you didn't cover it well, that you go back and paint over it good, because if you don't want to see your graphite lines, then you need to make sure that you erase them back. When I transferred my pattern on here, after I transferred my basic shapes, I went with my white eraser and I erased all my lines way back so that I could just barely see them. Over here it didn't matter as much because this is darker colors, but on your lighter colors you want to try and get rid of as much of the graphite lines as you can and still be able to see your lines. Make sure when you're dusting your eraser stuff off, this stuff, that you brush it off away from where your paint is, because you don't want it getting in your paint. Okay, we're going to start working on the background here, and I have on my palette Boysenberry Pink, Blue Harbor, and Avocado. I think I might put just a little bit of Peacock Teal out. I don't know if I'm going to want this color, but we'll have it out just in case. So with these paints I'm going to create some washes, and I'm going to put some water over here on my palette, so if I need to thin it down more I can just go over here and get some clean water and thin it down. So I'm going to start with my pink, and I want a wash of color. I don't want it to be very dark. I want it to be mostly water, very, very sheer. So you can see how that's mostly water. It's still a little bit, got a little bit more paint in it than what I would like. Okay, so I am going to take my brush is full of paint and water now, so I'm going to go lay it on my paper towel and get the excess water out of it. And when I load paint, which I'm going right back to this puddle I made and I'm loading up, then I'm going to touch the tip of my brush. It will just wick out any excess paint that might have, or water that might have built up on the end of my brush. I want to have my mop brush in one hand. Okay, so we're just going to start. I know I want to put probably some roses up here and here. We're going to put roses on the cup. So in those areas, I want to wash in a little bit of this pink in here. And I have just a tad bit too much water. So I'm going to take my mop brush and soften that. Use your mop brush dry. That's a little bit too much water, so let me mix a little bit more paint in it. And get a little bit more color here. And then we're going to mop. Gently soften. That's still wet. I'm going to put a little bit on each one of these areas right here. And I'm going to mop. I need to clean my mop brush. It's very important to clean your mop brush. And to do that, you just go to a damp place on your paper towel, clean it out, and then a dry place and dry it off. Because as you're mopping, you're going to pick up paint. So now I've got a little bit of a hard edge there that I don't like, so I'm just going to re-dampen it and take my mop brush and try and soften that out. Okay, I'll have to come back and put more there. Go down to this bottom one, or this other side one here. This one won't get too carried away because we're into our blueberries there. So let me go back up to this top one and redo it. Gently, gently, gently. Picked up a lot of paint there. Now I have a hard line. I think that's from my previous one. So I'm going to scrub in some water there. And then mop that. Soften that out as best I can. Since that's at the top, we want it to look pretty soft. Okay, now we can add some of this color on our edges here. We're going to come in and add some greens and other colors too, so we don't want to make everything pink. You know, just put a little bit here and there. Just take your mop brush and soften it all out, keeping it soft. Clean your mop brush, especially when you're going to change to a different color, which we're getting ready to do. So now I want to take a little bit of Blue Harbor. We're going to do it the same way. Just mix water in it and make a little wash out of it. Okay, and now we're going to go figure out where we want to put some of this blue. And I think I want some blue up in here. So I just dabbed it on, so now I'm going to mop. I'm going to try and stay on the outer edges of that and soften the outer edges when I mop. I think I might bring this up onto the corner just a little bit. Okay, these are very light sheer colors. We can always go back and repeat it. So I would rather that you start it out with some lighter colors. That one was quite a bit darker. So I want to keep one side of the mop brush in the paint and the other side out of the paint. So I don't get paint all in my mop brush. Really like that edge there. Don't like how it turned out. So just a damp brush and your mop brush and mop it up and soften it. And we can come back and repeat that because that one's not near dark enough. water. Mop. This water will dry very quickly, so you need to have your damp brush. Oops, wrong brush. That's why I was depositing paint, because I was using the wrong brush. Handy. So if you get any hard edges, you can just quickly wipe that back. Wrong brush. I'll get my brushes organized here in just a second. Just mixing up a little bit more here. All right, let's mop it. I like to mop as quickly as I can. It'll help keep any hard edges from getting there. Okay. So that's our Blue Harbor and our Boysenberry Pink. So let's go get some avocado. We're going to do it the same way. We're going to water it down. It's about 90 to 95% water and 5 to 10% paint, depending on how dark you want this to be. So I want to put some greens all up in here. Kind of bright, but it's not really a bright green. Okay, I think I want to put some of this green kind of down in here, because if we bring some leaves around, we'll want some background greenery in there. Guess that needed to go over here. Need to clean my mop brush off. Not too much paint built up in it. And you don't have to do every side the exact same way. You can do random stuff and just create a nice little border. Okay, I see two hard edges that I don't like, and one of them is right here. So I'm going to try and rub and push that paint a little bit. The other one's over here. Now this one I might try and scrub with a damp brush and just remove some of that paint off of there. I love painting with washes and glazes and stuff like that. And we'll come back and go around the outer edge with probably a darker color, but we'll see after we get some flowers on there. We don't want it to get too awful busy on the outer edges, because we want our eyes to stay here. So we might have to go in and lighten that up a little bit. We'll see how that works. Okay, so while we've got these paints out, I'm going to get a smaller brush, I think. I want to apply some of these washes, just a little bit of these colors, onto the cup and saucer. And I don't want very much of this at all. I just want it to be some background stuff. So I'm going to have my mop brush and my damp brush. If I don't like it, I'm going to quickly take it off. Okay, so I know I want to put some roses in random areas on this cup. So I'm going to put some background color in here. That one's not showing up very well. Let me get just a tad bit more paint. And I think I'm going to go to a flat brush because I can control the water a little bit more with a flat brush. So I'm going to a 10 flat. Okay, so let me try this again. I'm just going to do a circle, keeping the water edge to the outside. Kind of like a little bullseye float, if you've ever done one of those. So, a little bit more water. Just want to create some soft color on here. And some random places. Maybe a little bit coming off the edge over here. Too much hard line there. Well, you could probably put just a touch on the handle, maybe a little bit down here on this base. Okay, let's put some on the plate. Paint too far over on my brush here. Oh. Remixing some paint here. These are very, very soft, sheer colors. Just in some random little places on here. Judge of where they go. Okay, we just don't want to get carried away. I might put one more up here on the very edge of the cup. So, in the end, I just had a little bit of that wash of color on the very edge of my brush here, the very edge of it. Okay, we're going to do that with some green as well. Just a little wash of green. And your mop brush. So I want to put this green kind of around the pink area that I put on here. Creating some little random places. This is where we can put some leaves, maybe soft leaves coming out from behind our roses. It's still very soft. I kind of adjusted my lighting because I was getting a lot of shadow on my surface. I'm still getting a little bit, but not as much. Okay, out here I definitely want to keep it a little bit softer back here. That's more in the shadowy areas. Up a little bit more wash here. I'm just keeping it on the toe of that brush instead of letting it go all the way across. I mop right on it so I can. First I do the edges because I don't want the edges to get hard, and then I mop right on the whole thing. I need to wipe my mop brush off occasionally if it gets paint built up on it. We don't want to transfer that paint. I think I'll put some on the edge here. Just a tiny bit back here. We're going to mop that to soften that back there. And I can put a little bit along the edge up here. A little bit on the handle next to this pink. Maybe a little bit up here next to the pink on the cup there. So that's kind of given us a placement where we're going to place our roses on here. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take a small round brush and we're going to take that wash and add just a little bit more paint to it. And we're going to add just some like background stroke leaves. So we still want these to be sheer. We just don't want them to be quite as sheer as the wash that we just put on there. So if I feel like it's too dark, I'm just going to touch it back with my finger. And you can use a bigger round brush or a filbert brush if you feel like you can do it better with a filbert. We just want to put some random kind of leaf shapes on here. When I touch them back with my finger, it does the same thing as when I use a mop brush. But I've got my fingers more handy, so it's a little bit easier. I'm going to make some bigger leaves down here. Just touch those back. It's just a washy little color here. I'm going to go back up to this one and make, I think I want to make a big one over here, so I'm going to just paint over what I already did and make that a bigger one. Okay, let's put some little ones down here. We don't need too much going on down here on the plate. These are just delicate little washy strokes. A little bit bigger one down here. A bigger one on this side. A couple little ones back here. Okay, so those are just washy, washy, washy little leaves. Nothing fancy, or you don't have to worry about getting a lot of detail. You just kind of want a leaf shape. Okay, so now we're going to start adding our roses. I'm going to put a little fresh boysenberry out. And let's see. I'm I put out some cranberry wine and some cool white. Okay, so to make our roses, we're going to take our boysenberry pink, and we're just going to make a little. I want to make that a little bit lighter than that. I don't want these to be great big, to be bold and bright. So I'm going to thin this down with a little bit of water. I'm just using a filbert brush. You can use a round brush. I put a couple of roses up in here. Kind of group them together. My brush seems to want to be separating here a little bit. Okay, so we're just basically making some little circles on here. I want to come back and add some leaves back in there. Now down here I want to keep it much lighter. This can be a half of a rose here. A couple of little ones here. You don't have to have the same amount of rose in every place. Okay? Alright, so that's our basing for our roses. Okay, let's float a little bit in the center here, and I'm going to use a small brush. This one still might be too big. You can use an angle brush. I'm just going to use a small little chisel flat brush. And you want to determine where your center is. So I want the center on this one to be here. And so we want the base to also be floated in. This is with cranberry wine, so I'm going to go and do all of my centers and let them dry, and then come back and do all of my bases. So when we're doing the centers here, it's basically just a little C stroke. I don't have very much paint on my brush. Just creating a little C stroke. This is a very, very little one. It could be a bud. This one too. You don't want your rose centers to all be going the same direction. I probably already said that, but two look like little buds. One here. This is a very, very teeny tiny little float here. Here. Okay, now I'm going to come back and put some on the bottom edges. Try not to cover up all of my boysenberry. I probably should have grabbed like a 3/8 or quarter inch angle. Might have been a little bit easier to do. I'm keeping you on camera. All this spinning around here. Okay, these little buds. I'm going to put just a little bit at the base of those. These are some of the easiest little rosebuds. I wanted this cup to look a little more on the antique side, so that's why I'm going with a simpler rose on here. See if there's any of the bases that need touching up, or any of the centers. We want the centers to be nice and dark. Okay, and even though we can't see a rose over here, I'm going to put just a little bit, well, maybe put some water on my brush, just a little bit over here of that darker pink cranberry wine. Okay, now we want to start adding some of our detail lines on here. So since my roses are so small, I'm going to do it with a liner brush. And I'm going to go into some cool white and thin it down with some paint. And I'm just going to create an edge. Forgot to do this one. Kind of wiggle it, you know, don't make it a straight little line. Put a little bit on the back edge too of the top. Try and keep it on the pink so it doesn't blend in with your background. Okay, now we're going to take boysenberry pink and cool white, and we're just going to stroke some strokes on here to give the illusion of some petals. I need to thin my paint a little bit. It's still too thick. So I'm just going to add some water to it. And we can create some petals, the illusion of petals on here by using these two colors. So I'm using the white first, which I probably should use the pink first. It probably would work out better, but I'm going against the rules here. Okay, let me go into some boysenberry pink and thin some of that down, and we'll add some of these strokes in here. We can come out past our rose. Don't feel like you have to make your roses look perfect. We want this to be looking antique-y and old. And I have a huge cup and saucer collection, and I have a big variety of different patterns. No two cup and saucers that I own are alike. Makes it very interesting. I have to put some leaves around that little bitty one there. So, let me get some thin green here. I probably need to wash some green in to the background first. And then put some leaves in here. Boy, that paint dried up faster than I could fill my brush. Okay, I think I will go in here and add a bigger leaf coming off of this one. That might be too much. Take that down just a little bit. You can always tell when you got paint on your fingertips when you go to try and rub a color out. If it turns a completely different color, then you have paint on your finger. So you can take a white eraser and dampen your paint if it has not set into the piece yet. And you can very, very gently erase the top layer of paint back. Once it dries, it's a little bit harder, and the harder you rub, the more chances you have of going all the way through the base coat of your piece. Okay, I feel like this one needs some more pink washed in around it. Thin some of my pink down and get my mop brush ready. This one here, I feel like it needs some background pinkness going on in there, like I lost it. So if I feel like I've completely covered up my pink in the background, just go in and wash some in and mop it. Try not to get hard lines. And that's going to create that softness back in there. Too hard of a line there. Didn't like it. And you can do this with the green as well if you feel like all your green got covered up. Just bring some of that antique softness back in here. Clean my mop brush because it's full of paint. It's transferring it everywhere. That looks good. That's nice and soft. And I really like how that looks. Okay, we want to try to start defining the shape of the cup where we can see it a little bit better. So I've got some Snow White, and I'm just going to follow the shape of the cup, almost outlining it where we can see it. Now down here, the bowl part, we'll want it to have a little bit of white on it so we can separate the edge from the base. And this is just a little bit of Snow White. We just want to get the shape. We don't want to cover it with white. I'm going to put some along the upper edge here. We're going to put some gold around the edge here, so some of this we won't see. Okay, and the plate where we put our white paint, or our straight cool white, we want to put this around. And we might have to repeat this white because our base color is so close to straight white. Okay, we can do some hit and miss stuff there. I'm gonna go along this side again. In the curve part, you would normally be a shadow, but we're going to make that a little bit brighter in there. And then along the bottom, okay, and we can put a little bit of white on this base. I think I'll go to my liner brush for that and get a little reflective, reflection there on the bottom of the base. And let's do it on the edges so we can define those edges a little bit more. Oh, while I have this liner, let's do some on the handle. I want to brighten up our handle, so I'm just going to like pull a highlight line, kind of. It's a hit and miss thing. It doesn't need to be everywhere. Okay. And I think one more brighter highlight with our liner brush. We want to create some bright highlights here on the edge of the cup. I think one more place that we want a definite highlight to be seen is back here on this edge. So I definitely want to brighten this up, kind of going down into the cup a little bit. That's a little bit thick paint there. I didn't thin it down near enough. Okay, let's do a little bit of shading on this. So I'm going to use a 10 curb flat. I love to use the curb flats. We're going to go into a little bit of that boysenberry pink, and when I say a little bit, I mean we're going to do a sheer color of this pink, because if I don't like it, I want to go and wipe it off. And I'm not sure I want to do pink. I think I'm going to change that to Blue Harbor, because that's a little bit of the color that we mixed in with our cool white. And I think it will give us a better shadow color. So again, we want to keep this sheer. More water on my palette, because I want to be able to have access to water very quickly if I feel like this is going on too dry. Okay, so we want to pick our shading places on our cup. So we know we're going to have some shading here. And this is very tight here, so stay up on the toe. And if you are using an angle brush, you can go to a quarter eighth inch angle for these tighter places here. Very sheer. All right, I'm going to stay up on the toe of my brush because I'm going to be in a tight area here, and I want to go around the underneath of that bowl. It's very sheer paint, so it's going to go on very easily. I want to go a little bit underneath this edge, where it will set the deeper part. I'm going to mop that because I really want to take that back. And that's probably a little bit too dark for me. So I'm going to wet it. And remove it. Find a clean finger to mop that up with. I'm going to try that again. So I'm going to need more water in my brush this time, because I want that to be really soft on that edge. I don't want, yeah, there we go. Nice, soft. Nice and soft. And just mop on that outer edge there. See, it's just barely some color. Okay, now we want to go around the base of this cup. Some shadow around this cup. And I'm going to mop. Kind of got it on my cup there. I don't want it on my cup. Okay, let's put a little bit of this back here. I think I'm going to have to dirty up my paint a little bit with some green. I feel like down here it's a little bit too bright. So let me get some avocado out. And my blue harbor is already out. So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to dip into my blue. You see, I have hardly any paint on my brush. Dip barely into my green. And we're just dirtying up that blue right there. And we're going to put this back here. And these more shadow areas. A little bit more here on my brush because I had very little paint, so it wasn't going to go very far. This might be a little bit too dark here. I want it darker in that V area back there. Stay off of my cup. Come back and clean that up with some white. I want to go around down here a little bit. Okay, we need some of this color. Mix just a little bit more. Okay, we need this down underneath this edge here. On the toe. I like that green-blue mix better, so I'm going to go over all these areas where I put the... where I put the just blue. So it was probably 2-to-1 on the mixing there. Two blue and one green. But still very, very, very sheer. Oop, you probably didn't see that. I was just going back over the areas that I did. So now I want to redo my white. And this is Snow White on my edges. Not really liking this down here, so I think what I'm going to do is streak some white in here, create a little more highlight on this edge. I don't want to cover up my roses there, if I can help it. I'll go back to my flat brush here. I feel like I can get a sharper edge here. I feel like I just completely covered that one up, so I'll take some of the white paint off of it. Alright, let me wide angle out. That will give me better perspective. Yeah, see, I'm not liking that there. On the edge of that cup. So I'm going to pull some white in. Maybe. I've got it too thick. I'm going to pull it in on this edge because we've got our brighter highlight here, which I'm going to intensify that. A little bit more on the handle, which I don't think it's going to show up near as well on the handle. Okay, while I've got my liner brush, since this side's going to be lighter, I'm going to pull a little bit of highlight in there. And maybe on this edge. Maybe not quite so far down. On this edge, I'm just using the liner brush now with Snow White. Curve those because I want them to show the curve on the cup a little bit more. Okay. A little bit more out here, I think. And I might put a little reflective highlight over here. I still don't like this area down here. But I want some highlights going through here on the plate. Alright, I'm not too sure about those highlights on there, but we're going to leave them for now. And we'll come back to this and do some final tweaking at the end. That's what I usually do. I wait till I'm done at the end and do a little bit of tweaking. I think before we say we're done with this cup for now, let's put some gold on here. Now, I've got two options of gold here for you. I've got metallic. This is the only gold that I had, is Emperor's Gold. You could put silver on this. Silver would look beautiful too. I'm not sure that I have silver. So you can use this. It's DecoArt metallic paint. You can use, if you have any of this media paint, it goes on clear or white like this, but then it dries gold. So I'm going to put a little bit of this out on my palette, this media paint, and show you what it looks like. You can just barely see a little bit of gold in that. So this is what I am going to put. I'm going to load my liner brush. And this is what I'm going to put on the edge of the cup. And we're just going to have it on the front edge because it's the only edge that we're going to see. We won't see the back edge. And hopefully when this dries, we'll see some bright gold paint there. Or not bright, but nice gold paint. And I think I want to go on the edge of the handle. And this is all optional stuff. If you don't want to do this, then just add extra white highlight on the very edge of the top. Let that dry. I might have to go in and because I've got a light color behind it, I might have to go in and add a darker color under it. And we want the edge of our plate to have the gold on here. I think the darker that your paint is behind this, the brighter the gold will be. Because I used this on my grapes project that I did. And it was very, very bright on there. I could see it really well. But it's because it was a dark color. So when I lift it up, you can see it. You can see it a lot better. Okay, so I'm going to leave that for now. And we'll come back to the cup when we get done with the blueberries and see what we need to do with the cup. Okay, we're going to start on the blueberries. I went ahead before I did the highlights on all this to put my roses along the outer edge there. Okay, so for our blueberries, I am going to use a 10 curved flat. And I'll have a mop brush handy. Alright, this is how I like to do my blueberries. I am going to dampen the blueberry first. Actually, I'm not going to use my curved flat. I'm going to use a round brush. Number one or number three, whatever you have. I'm going to take navy blue. And I think I'm already dry. I need to have this pretty damp. I'm going to take navy blue and tap it along this edge. Okay, and some blue harbor in the middle. And some cool white along this edge. And then I am just going to tap. I just wiped the paint. I did not wash my brush each time. But as I tap into each color, I'm going to go remove the paint off of my brush. And I just want to blend them where they meet. Kind of give it a little textured look on the blueberry. Not really textured, because they're not textured, but they have this like soft, almost marbled effect to them. So we're just going to tap blend these colors. So we just want to get three areas of different color on there. Okay, so let me do that. I'm going to do it with one up here on the top so that, okay, let me see my pattern. This one's going to be on top of all of them, so I'll do this one. Okay, so I've got this one to where the black area is right here. So I'm going to take the navy blue and tap it all around the outer edge. Now, I've done blueberries before on another project that I have on my pears, my fruit medley. But I didn't use these colors. I used some different colors on them. Okay, so now I'm going to wipe my brush out, and I'm just going to start tap blending. Because I want to have that little bit of mottled look, and you can't get it just by floating. And we don't want that white, that bright white in there, so that's why I'm mixing the paint with it. Try and keep the shape of your blueberry. We will come back and float on these. And I want to have a little boo-boo here. I want to try and remove that. It might already be dry, so when I shade under that, I'll have to take care of it. Okay. I think I'm going to have to go to a bigger brush here. Let's dampen another one. I'll go back and do this one. And then I'm going to go off camera and finish the rest of these so that you don't have to watch me do them all. Because they're all going to be the same. Okay, so this one is behind that one, so we're going to make it darker here. And I already got outline of that one. So let me clean that up real quick. I'm going to go into the Blue Harbor, which was our base color on these. And a little bit of Snow White. I actually have the top of this one being over here, so I'm going to put a little bit more dark over there. I'm going to wipe my brush off, and then I'm going to start tap. Just tap, tap, tap. Blend, blend, blend. Give it that little bit of mottled look. I'm going to wipe my brush off as I pick up paint. Got a crazy wild hair on this one. Keep tapping. I have to get a different brush. This one is not wanting that little hair to go away. Okay, this one looks really nice. I really like the mottled look of this one. So, can you see that mottled? Probably not because of the glare of the wet paint. But it's got a nice gradation of color in there on that one. And that's exactly what you want. So, when they get dry, if you don't feel like they look like they have that gradation of color very well, then just do it again. It's not going to hurt anything at all. Like this one, I don't feel like it's got a very good gradation of color. So I'm going to do that one again. So I'm going to go finish all these up, and then we're going to come back and work some more on these blueberries. All right, we're going to get ready to start adding some shading onto these blueberries. I've got them all done. So first I'm going to take some Payne's Gray and we're going to float this color. So when I load my brush for floating, I dip into the paint. I've got my water damp, my brush dampened with water, and then I just like to load back and forth like this in a little V, as opposed to like this back and forth. I think that requires a lot of wrist movement, and so I want to keep moving my wrist back and forth to a minimum. Okay, so this blueberry is on top of these two. So we're going to shade behind this one. And over here, we're going to shade here. Kind of lost my shape on my blueberry here, so let me... that back up a little bit. Okay, then this one back here will be shaded back here. I want to shade this one here because it is behind. That part of the blueberry is behind this one here. I kind of messed up the shape of that one there, it looks like. So we can smooth that out. Reshape it with our shading. Okay, I'm using a 10 curved flat. You can use whatever brush you feel most comfortable with. I prefer to use a bigger brush. It holds more paint, and I don't feel like I have to work near as hard. Okay, I want to go and shade these on the lower edges a little bit. Sitting on the ground. This is still with Payne's Gray. And this one down here, it's going to have mostly highlight on that edge, but we want to put a little bit. And then up here. Okay, now I'm going to dip the toe of my brush in my Payne's Gray. So I'm just dipping it in there. Okay, so I've got a little load of paint there, and I want to come in here, and this area here, I just want to darken that. You can kind of create a little flower star shape if you would like. I think on my pattern I drew little almost star shapes on it, and it's just this one here I'm just going to darken down in there. one's on top here. I'm just using the toe of that brush, put a little paint in there, and I just kind of pull it out. Very, very easy to do. Okay. I want a little bit more highlight on here. I'm going to get some cool white out. And I'm going to take my liner brush and add I just want to put a couple little dots in here. Nothing big, just some little wherever the highlight would be. This one's not going to have much highlight on it. This one's going to be a lot of highlight up in here. Okay, just the little dibby-dabby thing. Don't get too carried away with it. Don't need a whole lot. This one needs to be a little bit brighter here because it's got a little more focal point. Okay, and then we're going to take some ultramarine blue. Okay, here we go. With our ultramarine blue, I'm just going to create a little wash of this color. And I'm going to keep it on the toe of my curved flat here. And I want to brighten up these blueberries just a little bit by putting this wash on here of ultramarine blue. Now, you can not, it's perfectly fine if you don't want to do this step. I want to get those blueberries a little bit brighter. And I think we might repeat the shading maybe in a couple of places. Pull this Payne's gray color up just a little bit. And you can just go in and shade with the navy blue if you want. You don't have to do it with the other. Okay, we're going to move on to the leaves. Okay, we're going to start shading on the leaves with Hauser Dark Green at the base of these leaves. We won't need a whole lot of detail on these. I'm not sure how well that's showing up there. I feel like I have some issues with my lighting today. Oops, stay off my blueberry. I'm just going to mop those gently. I want to put a vein down the center, so I'm just using the tip of this brush. I'm using the 12 curved flat. I'm just going to pull a vein. I'm trying to figure out which way I want to pull this one, so I'm going to pull it on this side. We don't want it to go all the way to the tip, so if you get it to the tip, kind of take it back a little bit. We're going to highlight with, I've got olive green. We'll see. I might have to add some avocado to that to take it down. It might end up being too bright, so I'm going to put some avocado out. Whoa! Didn't quite want that much avocado out. And I am just going to add a tiny bit of avocado to my olive green just on my brush and mix it. And I'm going to put this out on the outer edge of the leaf. Clean that paint up there. We're going to try and keep that little pointy edge going. So if you haven't done your little wiggle on your edge, go ahead and do that when you do this color. Just a little sharp on the edges, just little spikes. highlight next to the vein of this mix. So on the opposite side that you put your shading on, we'll just put a little highlight on there. Okay, now I want to go just straight olive green, olive green. And I want to get the very highest places on these leaves. So we know our light's coming this way. This side of the leaf is going to be a lot brighter. It's just a little sawing, pushing the paint up on the in those jagged edges. And then for my final there, I'm going to do my liner brush with some olive green. And just kind of in the center. Not the leaves. The veins anyways. I think I'll go over that brightest edge one more time with olive green. I want that a little bit brighter. Getting very close to being done with this project. Sorry, my brush didn't have enough water in it there. Now I feel like it's got too much water. I think that's going to finish up the leaves on our blueberries because we don't want a ton of detail on there. Okay, I don't feel like our gold stands out because the underneath color of that gold is not dark enough to make it stand out, because this product is going to go with what it's going to determine the brightness by whatever is underneath it. So we're going to go with the Emperor's Gold, and I think I will add maybe just a touch of burnt umber in it to tone it down, because I don't have any other gold, and this is a bright gold, and I want it to be a little duller. So I've got my Emperor's Gold here, and I'm just going to get a little bit of burnt umber. Make a bigger amount here. That's not going to be enough to get the job done. Okay, just kind of dirtied up that gold just a little bit. Let's thin it down with a little water so it will flow off of my brush nicely. We're going to go around the top edge of the handle. Okay, let me mix a little bit more. Go on the plate edge. Now again, this is an optional step. If you do not want to do this, you do not have to do it. I did not do this with my other gold, but I think out here on this back edge, we're just going to give a little hint of some gold back here. Very thin line. Very thin. Okay, we need to shade underneath our berries here. Okay, and I'm going to shade under them with a mix of avocado. And since I used burnt umber in with my gold, I now have it in my palette somewhere, so I'm going to use some avocado and burnt umber. I am just going to brush mix them. It's about equal amounts. I just dipped into each color one time. Okay, we want to push some of this back here and use the wet edge of my brush to kind of pull it out. I probably have too much water in my brush here. I just want that edge damp. I don't need it sopping wet. Okay, back here. Bit more paint mixed up here. Now you can add another leaf down here on this one if you want. Kind of wiggle that. Come out and put a little bit of shading underneath that. That leaf there. Okay, I want to go underneath the plate here a little bit. Although our shadow should technically be more on the right side because our highlight's on this side. We should have more shadow on the left than we do on the right. Okay, mix me up a little bit more. Okay, a little bit more shadow over here. Okay, pull it out. Get my mop brush. Already drying, so mopping it is going to be futile. I'm going to put a little bit of this mix of color over here on this side of the cup because it will be the darker edge of the cup, or the saucer, I mean. I might put just a little glazing of this here, this more shadowy side. Mop that. Try to soften it out. Is that just that dirty mix of avocado and burnt umber? Kind of messed up my shape down here on my plate. Too much paint. Shape. that back a little bit. Putting this color in all the places where I kind of put a shadow. Except on this side, because I want the shadow over here to not be quite as dark as the shadow on this side. Okay, let's wide angle out. See how this is looking. Got a little wobbly on the edge of my cup, but you know, I'm not an exact artist, so I'm not going to worry about that. I think down here on the edge of my plate I've got it a little bit too large here. So I'm going to take my shadow color, which was that avocado and burnt umber mix. And I am going to take some of this away. And make it smaller. Repeat that on this side to cover up that white a little bit more. A little bit darker back up in there. Wherever there's a V where something meets, that's where you want your darkest area to be. Okay. I'm going to go take a photograph of this and then come back and see what else we need to do to it. Okay, I want to add some final touches around the border here. We've got blue here. We've got a little bit of blue in our shading here. So I want to put a little bit more blue in the background with that blue harbor. So up here where we put the blue earlier, we're just going to put in some more. Mop that. And over here, definitely need more water here. And if you're doing big mops like this, you know, where you know you're going to use a lot of color and need water, and you're unsure about how much water to have in your brush, you can pre-dampen this area first. If that helps you. Okay, so let me show you how if you pre-dampen it. So I just put a little bit of water on there. I'm going over and picking up a little bit of paint. I still have water on my brush, but it's gonna, that's probably a little bit too much water. So I'm gonna have to mop and wipe my brush off. Mop and wipe my brush off because it's just going to pick up too much paint. Okay. Put a little bit more blue up here. Bring it out a little bit more. So let's come down here. This is a very quick project. You can sit down and probably do this whole project in a couple of hours. Got a little bit too much water down there. So I'll probably have to come back and repeat that one because it probably will just fade away. And any place out here on these outer edges where you feel like your color is not as bright as you want it to be, just go and float some more. Just like I'm doing here, you know, dampen it, put a little bit of washy color on there, and then mop it out. Okay, so we're going to do this one. Pick up some paint. Got a lot of paint on my brush there. With my mop brush, I'm removing some of that paint because I had just a touch more than I wanted to have on there. Yeah, but I've got too much water on this section. Just a little bit more paint. Ooh, that's way too much paint. All right, I need to get to mopping this before all that water evaporates. Right in it. Clean my mop brush so I can go right back in here and not carry that paint where I don't want it. Okay, I think I might darken up a little bit of the green. So I'm going to do that with the pre-dampening. Pick up some avocado. Put it on there. Mop, mop, mop it away, or mop it to soften it. I probably wind up doing all of the colors here because I don't want it to, I don't want one color to be not the same. Value as the others. I'll go back in and do my pink as well, which is the boysenberry pink. Oop, got it on my rose there. Don't want it on my rose. Clean that off. I'm going to clean my mop brush off really good because I don't want to transfer green when I do my pink. Get some boysenberry out, and I think this will be just about a done project here. So I'm going to pre-dampen. I have a lot of pink areas here. My brushes mixed up. Pre-dampen, a little bit of paint, or a lot of paint. Let me bring that out just a little bit. Clean my mop brush off. Picked up a lot of paint on that one. Pre-dampen, I'm out of water in my brush, so. Reload that. Lots of paint there, man. Mop that one good. Clean my brush off. Now you want these colors to stay soft. If they look like they are too bright, and probably on here they look brighter than on the camera than what they do in front of me, so I'm going to put a little bit around my roses. Mop that. touch of color. And mop it. Soften it out there. Don't get it on your roses because you don't want to cover up your highlights on your roses. Okay, one more here. I think we might be able to call this one a done project, so we can sign it, seal it, and display it. All right, thanks for painting with me.